After about 2 months into the summer of 2024, one thing can be stated, it's hot outside. Several murders of high-profile members have occurred. That's why I intend to make this video to go through everything that has happened for those of you who haven't really followed along and who, rightfully so, focused on other things, like you should be during the summer. However, I will not go into depth about each murder, it will be more of a summary of what has happened. I'm counting from June 1st. The group that had the hardest time this summer is Paxtown 071, who have lost 3 members in less than 2 months. These huge losses are mostly a result of an internal beef going on within Paxtown. The internal beef stems from members backdooring each other, which has created different camps, much like what has been going on in Sirkon City Gangsters for a couple of years. First up was Lil Josh from Paxtown 071, who was killed on June 3rd in Paxtown territory after getting shot in the head and chest. Lil Josh was a well-known member and rapper. He was allegedly killed by Bullet and Jay Ski from Paxtown. Lil Josh was rumored to have backdoored Boss Block, also known as D-Block, from Paxtown in May 2019, which could be the reason for the killing of Lil Josh. Boss Block and Lil Josh were fighting an attempted murder together in 2014, however I don't know if it has something to do with Lil Josh backdooring him. Other backdoors have also occurred, for example Nasky, who was killed in July 2021. There was also a lot of controversy involved in the murders of Lil Don from Paxtown and LC Lee Van Blind from Taekwon World. Two weeks later, Paxtown lost another member, G Slim, who was an older member and also was killed in Paxtown's territory. It is unknown if this death is part of the ongoing internal beef or if it was one of Paxtown's many enemies that was behind it. On July 2nd, one of the Paxtown members involved in Lil Josh's death, Bullet, was shot several times, including in the chest and jaw. Bullet, also known as Lil Chris, is still in critical condition and is fighting for his life. A week later, Jay Ski from Paxtown, the second member rumored to have been involved in Lil Josh's death, was killed. Jay Ski, who was only 19 years old, was shot 13 times, including in the face, neck, chest and other parts of the body. He was killed in Paxtown territory. YIC, which is the other group they are beefing with within Paxtown, mocked Jay Ski heavily after the murder. Now we switch to Lamron and Taytown, who have each lost a member. On June 9th, Lamron lost OTF Trigger Black, who was found dead in an alley after getting shot. The territory he was killed in belongs to the set Low Life, which most of you have heard about before. Most of you have also heard about Taytown and Lamron, who were both part of 300 and who were basically the same thing back in the days, and that they now have beef with each other due to several reasons. This has caused other gangs to almost be forced to choose a side. For example, McBlock has sided with Lamron, and Low Life, who was involved in the JoJo hit, has sided with Taytown. Keep in mind, this is a very simplified explanation of the situation, there is a lot more to it than this which I could explain in a different video. Trigger Black was allegedly killed by C-Dub, also known as C-Money, from HBE, Low Life. C-Dub was arrested for the murder and it allegedly happened during a dice game. Later that day, a well-known member named Kenken from Taytown was murdered. Kenken was shot and killed in the 11,500 block of South State Street, which is considered GT territory. It is unknown who or which gang killed Kenken or if it is connected to the ongoing feud with Lamron. However, Shields was dissing heavily after the murder. CMB Marco also had his chains taken by DTE a few days before the murder, and Kenkan was dissing Brick Squad heavily on social media in the days leading up to the murder. It was basically a lot of things happening before the murder. It could have been anyone. Another high-profile murder was that of Lil Skoom from Burly Boys / Roblox, also known as GME. Lil Skoom and Lil Will from Shorty Mob were arguing with someone in the 700 block of 89th Place, which is considered Geesky Gang territory. Suddenly, the individual they were arguing with opened fire on them. Skoom was hit multiple times in the chest and Lil Will was shot in the legs. Lil Skoom's life could not be saved and was pronounced dead at the hospital. Lil Will was taken to the hospital in fair condition. Lil Skoom was a very successful rapper with millions of views on YouTube. He was also the cousin of Vert from Drill City and was close with Bloodhound Lil Jeff. Lil Skoom was allegedly killed because he played both sides. He was very cool with Shorty Mob but was at the same time cool with Get Busy Gang / Hootie Gang, specifically friends of Lil Curtis, also known as 30, who had been killed in 2022 by Drench Gang. Shorty Mob / Drench Gang, who are subsets of NLMB, is at war with Get Busy Gang / Hootie Gang. Lil Skoom was allegedly backdoored by Risky Road. Turbo Hawk Hemp from Risky Road was the alleged killer. The most known murder this summer is of course that of Bloodhound Lil Jeff from Drill City. He was an up-and-coming rapper but was mostly known for being a killer and shooter with multiple bodies. Lil Jeff was killed in Trap City Hood while doing a hit. He was chasing a man up towards a porch but was then shot in the chest 19 times himself by one or two individuals from inside the house. Lil Jeff was then carried away from the scene by Q50 and Vert from Bloodhound. Lil Jeff was later pronounced dead at University of Chicago Medical Center. I will be doing a longer video on Bloodhound Lil Jeff which will be released soon. He was allegedly killed by Trap City. Another high-profile member who lost his life this summer is Twin from THF46. Twin was shot in the neck and shoulder inside a home in Grimy Gang Hood. He was pronounced dead at the scene. It is unknown who killed him, but everything indicates that he was snaked. However, there is also a different theory circulating that says it was a botched robbery, that Lil Twin and Twin tried to rob somebody and that it went wrong and that Lil Twin ran. One dude on Instagram instantly started mocking Twin and claiming the body, however I don't know if he is falsely claiming or not. However, there are many indications that he is lying. A third trilogy says that Twin robbed someone in O Block months before and was therefore killed for it. However, several O Block members paid homage after his death. As many of you already know, Twin was also a rapper. This was THF's third loss for the year along with SK and TP. Another infamous member that lost his life this summer was Lil Wap from DTD, who was killed on July 6th. He was walking on the train tracks in Moose Block territory when two people approached him and exchanged gunfire with him. He was shot multiple times and was later pronounced dead at the hospital. He was a rapper but also a main factor in the streets for DTD. He was also the little brother of Guap from DTD, who was killed in 2013. Wap Gang was created in his honor. The snakes from Rawtown mocked him heavily after the murder and pretty much claimed it as their work. However, there is a chance that it could have been their longtime rivals Pax Town that was behind it. Then, of course, there's the murder of DJ from 800, who was shot and killed on July 11th. The shooting took place on the I-94 Dan Ryan Expressway between 79th and 83rd Streets. TJ was in a car with Lil Mike from 650 when shots were fired at their vehicle. They crashed, and TJ was later pronounced dead at the hospital. Lil Mike fled the scene but was later apprehended for questioning. Rumor has it that Kane from MCB killed TJ in retaliation for TJ stealing his gun while Kane was asleep on July 10th, the day before the murder. Allegedly, Kane killed TJ within 24 hours of the theft. Kane was close friends with Lil Mike from 650, who was in the car with DJ, explaining DJ's presence around him. TJ was a famous 800 member. He was a shooter, killer and troller on the internet. He have also been featured in interviews and have done a couple of songs. Rest in peace to all the fallen members. It's important to note that several more members have lost their life this summer than those I mentioned. I highlighted only the most high-profile cases. Let's pray for a safe August in Chicago. Thank you for watching the video.